before the days of smartphones and digital cameras, we used to have cameras that take pictures or real films. And we had to send them to be developed, and then a couple of weeks later, we received some photos. And we usually loved those photos and would like to keep them in big albums. And a couple of weeks ago, I found one of my albums. And in one of the photos, there was my grandfather. At that photo, he was 60 years old. And then I remembered him. He was sitting at his corner, reading newspaper, virtually not going out, just living the life. And then there was another photo of my mother. At that photo, she was over 60. But I recall that at that age, she had friends going out, having fun, and traveling around the world. And look at me, I am over 60 now, and I'm talking to you using the WordPress, high technology. So I said, well, what's the difference from sitting in the corner all the way to a WordPress conference? Well, it's technology. We have to use technology. So that became my ambition, to help seniors to use technology in their lives. And the biggest problem came out to be the other side of the technology, which we have to make the seniors use more. So talking about seniors, who has a senior in their lives? Almost everybody. Let's see. What is a senior? How do we define a senior? Somebody over 50? 55? 60? 50? Or 65? Well, that's the difference. Senior means different to lots of different people. If you are in a high school as senior, you are on the 12th grade, you are ready to leave the college, proms, SATs. And if you are in the college, that means something else. You are on your fourth year, leaving the fun things and going to corporate America. And if you are in military, seniority is totally different. It's one rank higher. And the guy, whatever he says, you have to do it. And for us, seniority is being old, really old. Well, did I mean old? It's not. We are just getting a version upgrade. We are not old. Well, 44.7 million is the number of Americans who are 65 and older. And in the next 18 years, Americans are turning over 65 with a rate of 8,000 a day. So there are lots of seniors are there, and they are coming into our market, I should say. In 2000, only 14% of the seniors who are 65 and older were using the internet. Today, the number is 58. It's growing, but it's not good enough. And the main reason is the technology is very new for seniors, and devices seems out of this world. They are not happy. So let's see what are their complaints, which we see almost every day. It was very nice when we had that remote control with on, off, volume up, volume down, channel up, channel down button. Now we don't know what to use that. About 72% of the seniors are not comfortable with the technology. And when they receive something like an update, they either ignore it or they say, oh good, install. And as soon as they install, they got that. Isn't this the end of the world? Upgrade failed? Or maybe there's something more. Just delete it. Well, some of the seniors could not understand the common symbols that we use. Well, here are some examples. The hamburger, the funnel, and that arrow, and the floppy disk. Well, I know floppy disk, I used a lot. It's to store something, but the last time I see it, it was 20 years ago. But it's for saving. And do you know what that hamburger button is? Well, menu, but how could you understand that? During my last presentation, everybody asked what that funnel is. Well, it's filter. And that should be back button. And there is this thing. We all know it's the number sign, right? Oh, they changed the name to pound sign. Now it's called hashtag. But don't misunderstand me. We want to learn. More than 70% of seniors would like to learn. So we need to help them to understand. And it's inevitable that you will be old, but seniors do not accept that they are old. So they want to pretend as young. And whenever youngsters bring in something, Facebook, Starbucks, Fitbit, Snapchat, seniors go into that arena. Well, the recent one was a selfie. Yes, we are in the selfie business too. Well, senior citizens are also very devoted. In the average, every day, they spend 2 hours in front of their computers. That's not something to be ignored. But of course, there is reality. We get old, we lose our sights, our visions decline, and we also have cognitive decline, our motor skills decline. And not only the seniors, but also the middle-aged adults, which are 45 years and older, has some form of vision problems. And 1 in 6 Americans has a vision problem. So this is a recent research that brought out that 16.5 million Americans use some kind of lenses or corrective devices when they use computers, which are not seniors. Anyway, our vision change, mainly our lenses change color, and it looks like we look through a yellow filter. I have an example for you. For most of us, these two colors look the same, but actually, it is not. Not only the small, relatively pastel colors look the same, but also there are some colors like navy, brown, black. Through a senior's eye, they look more or less the same. So, in order to solve the problems, what shall we do? We should start helping the seniors. They want to learn, and we want to follow your blog, see your, to buy your products, and they want to be involved in the technology. So here are some tips that we all should use in our designs to make our designs senior friendly. First, we should have a resize text button. We should not let them expand and make it smaller themselves. It should be a standard button. And then, of course, the fonts. It should be a straightforward, sans serif these days, and not scripted. Although it looks nice in the design, it's not understandable or solvable for seniors. Seniors also have a habit or custom from the newspapers. They always read left justified. So when you have it center justified or right justified, it's very, very hard for seniors to read that. And of course, there is color. To use the color is very important. it's not only for the seniors, but also for the colorblind people. In America, 8% of the Caucasian males are colorblind, and 0.2% of the females are colorblind. So it means that one every 20 visitors to your website has some form of colorblindness. Facebook, for example, is a very good example. It doesn't use red, green, or any other colors. And you guessed it, because Mark Zuckerberg is a colorblind, he doesn't see red or green. Blue is the only color that he is comfortable to see the shades. So that's why we have Facebook in blue shades. And, well, I was told not to say never, don't do it, but never use red on black. We see this way. So the new color should be black on white. And avoid reverse dropouts, shades, and maintain high contrast. I say white, but it could be gray, but it should be very high contrast. And here is a good example from our world. Everything is separated. You see the nice colors, except that red one. But a senior sees like that, and it's visible. Another example, Wall Street Journal. They also use different techniques that seniors need to understand. Subjects are separated, put in a small boxes, blocks, so they can separate what they want and what they don't. And also, try to use extra white space between the subjects or sections so that seniors could see what's going on where. And there, with the cognitive skills decline, we have other things that we have to go back, which is captchas. It's very easy to understand for some, but not for us. We cannot read them, we cannot understand that, and the first regular one doesn't even mean anything. They come up with a new one. Okay, he is not a robot, but what? And also this famous pop-ups. They don't know how to get rid of those pop-ups. When they start popping up, they either turned off their computer right away or they call me. And there is one pop-up from our world. Can you see "No thanks, I know WordPress" inside out button there that you have to cross? It's gray on white. So that's something that should be avoided. Well, as you know, the screen sizes get smaller and smaller and smaller, from our laptop computers to tablets to phones, now the watches, but our eyes are the same. Well, thanks to Tim Cook, by the way, he is 54, we'll be getting a bigger tablet, huge tablet. I am very anxious about that. So more seniors are very confused about the change of the size, so they expect everything to be similar looking. Well, I have an example from Twitter. This one is from the Twitter's big screen size, and the other one is from the cell phone. They are exactly the same day, same minute, but they look completely different. A senior thinks that they are coming from two different sites, two different things. So try to avoid that. I know it's mobile first, so start with mobile, but be more unified along their in the media. And also, as I said, our motor skills decline. It's very hard for a huge finger try to punch in small letters. And don't forget, we used to use mouse. Now, mouse is our finger. That's not sensitive, and it's a bit shaky than mouse. And I have numbers for the smartphone usage, and people think that seniors don't use smartphones for their daily activities. As you see, young people use for text messaging, but seniors do that too. They use it for internet, seniors do that too. Voice video calls, of course we use phones for calling. Well, email, almost the same numbers. Social networks, well, we are not there yet. Video and music, those are the things that we don't do. Why? Because of that hard searching, punching, doing. Well, back to WordPress again. Look at that. Very well designed. We know where to click. We know what to do. Enough white space. And now look, CNN. Where shall I click to read the rest of this story? Full story? Well, we can see that. Most of the seniors immediately click on the biggest thing on the site. In that case, the picture. And it doesn't do anything. Then they click the title. It doesn't do anything. You have to find that blue thing and click on that. The next thing is break information into short sections. Although we have longer attention span than the young ages, which has 5 and seniors have 20, when we start reading things, we forget the beginning. So we have to just divide them into short sections. And give instructions very clearly. If you want them to click on something, say it. Orange buttons does not work for us. And also, minimize the use of jargon, technical terms, and so on. For us, dashboard is something still in the car, not on WordPress. And scrolling. When you start scrolling on a tablet, that's very good. But when you start scrolling on a MacBook or a computer, when you go after 3-4 pages, we start saying, where was it? How do we go? So that comes with the conventional interaction elements. Go to the top, left, right. It should be very clearly explained what to do. And make it obvious what is clickable and what is not. We love to see the buttons as buttons. We love to see the pictures being pictures, not a link to another page or something. If there is a link, we know that it's blue and underlined. So if it's not blue and underlined, we don't want to click on it, unless it's a button. And make those clickable items easy to target and hit. We want to hit at our first try. We don't want to click, 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 and see if it works or not. And the most important thing is the back button. When we make a mistake, we want to go back. But back button should take us to the previous screen, not the home page, not somewhere else. We just want to go one step back. And that's the biggest design problem that we have these days. And if you want a feedback from the customer, be very, very clear. Explain what you want them to do. If you say, click on this button, put a timeline or something when you are downloading. Seniors don't wait and see what's going on. You should have a progress bar or a beach ball that's running around so that we say, okay, this computer is doing something. Otherwise, we continue clicking. And you know, this is a bonus thing. When seniors click, we still have the Windows experience of double click. And we click and click and click, And if you put the action items at the same location in different pages, we click that. So without knowing, we click the other one, we click the other one, and we end up somewhere that we never thought of it. And it's not good. And use the operating system's capabilities. These days, Windows, Mac OS X, Linux, they all have accessibility options. They have text sizing, they have color changing, they have upside down, left, right, whatever you want, they have built-in options. Utilize them. And don't forget, if you are designing for a tablet, seniors use tablet landscape. We don't use it portrait. We try to keep the biggest screen, just like the movie theater or TV. For some reason, we don't use the other way around. As I told, this is the max capabilities. They even have a text-to-speech converter. Put that in your website. It's there. And even if you have mouse or moving problems, that will also help you to solve that. Well, this is what Microsoft gives you. It has almost the same things. They give you shortcuts and all of those means for you to design your website so that it will be senior friendly. And don't forget, getting old is inevitable, and you all will be old. So design everything for your future self and help seniors. If you help seniors today, you will be helping yourself tomorrow. Well, oh, this was my, I said don't use it, right? Well, here I'll break up and have some questions, and after the questions, we'll go over some examples that I chose for you. Any questions, anything before we go? Thank you. Please.
I noticed when you were talking about the senior friendly fonts, both of those were sans serif fonts. You know, there is this argument that there are serif fonts, Times Roman or New Roman, that are more readable for paragraphs of text or in general. No. Did it just happen the two examples you showed were sans serif, or is that the point you're trying to make? Because the other examples you showed were more script.
Well, there is a big argument going on about that. It used to be sans serif, full stop. But a recent survey from Europe just came out this year, figured out that just because of that newspaper habit, serif fonts also work. Times Roman is the best example. But the problem with the new serif fonts are they are too close to each other. So if you have the letter spacing well, serif fonts well. So that's why I didn't put use sans serif, because that was a fight. But I tried to be on the majority side. But both fonts work as long as they have enough letter spacing. And also, there are some serif fonts which are style, not those. Any other? Please. Well, we will be coming to that. I have some sites which test your website, not only for the elderly, but for the colorblind. You would be able to choose which colorblind type they have, and you can see that. Well, to answer your question, elderly has different percentages of yellow shading. When you grow more old, sometimes you go through a brown filter rather than yellow. Sometimes it's clear, but we don't recognize that. When you are, let's say, 50, you think this is green. And then since you gradually go into yellow filter, your green changes, but your brain adapts to that. So we still tell it it's green. But when the designer designs green and a, let's say, a blue next to it, we try to lose the connection between that. That's my point. We have to be very choosing the contradicting colors among the designs. Please.
You may not be able to answer this question, but I'm going to throw it out there. Have you done much, have you given much thought or done any research on the user experience for seniors for strictly web-based perusal of the internet versus like apps on an iPad or a phone? And is there kind of a different experience there, whether somebody is, you know, browsing, accessing the internet through a browser, or actually using, you know, these little icons on the phone and clicking these individual apps?
Perfect question. That's my next presentation. yes, people prefer individual apps rather than going into Google or Safari or Windows Explorer as a search engine. They want to be able to go to their point and hit the target right away. Otherwise, they just want to, if it's a medical question, they want to go to an app which solves the medical question. If it's an email, they want to go to an email. They don't want to go to a Gmail account and then type in their password. That's the other thing. They hate to type username and password. So apps versus internet is my next presentation. I know we have we have time, okay?
Yes, well, bring you some water.
Please.
You know, I work with seniors.
Thank you.
One of the top things that you mentioned, but is password management. It's very, very difficult. And LastPass, if you can teach somebody LastPass.
Well, as I just mentioned, password username is something huge problem. As I earlier mentioned, they seniors are very afraid to give out the personal information because they are hacked and they create lots of problems for their wealth they want to keep. So it's very important to use, but LastPass and similar password management systems has to come up with a
senior
safe ways. Otherwise, it's still hard to type in something for them, and they have to convince the seniors that it's safe to use.
The other side of that is you just need a simple course to teach phishing and things of that nature.
Yeah. Please.
As we're on the phone and things move forward, I've been noticing with people who are a little older than I am, not quite seniors even, that as we add more and more iconography to be able to reduce the words on the screen, especially for the phone, that they just can't keep up. You know, that hamburger, never gonna learn. But yet it's always gonna be there until we come up with the tic-tac-toe thing, which is the mega hamburger.
Exactly.
What do you do about it?
Well, my solution to that is use the hamburger and put menu under it. Or if it's on the computer, when you hover it, it would say menu on it. Give the alternative, use the alt tags all the time, especially on photos, if it's clickable. Just click here. When I hover it or click on it, it should say what it's doing. I said, be very, very clear what you want this senior or the person to do that. It's not only for seniors, it's for everybody. We are coming with all interesting figures, icons or something. In that icons.com, there are 3,000 icons that some of them means the same. It's very hard to understand even for me that I use almost every day. Shall we go? Oh, please.
Everything you have said, I have been saying for the last 20 years.
Thank you.
Because so overwhelming. They have so much on the page. Like our wonderful WordPress, which I love, overwhelms me because there's so much. What do seniors prefer to see? What would be most helpful for them with the layout?
Well, that will be a very good segue to my other videos. The answer for that, they don't use it. When if it's overwhelming, if it's crowded, there are several newspaper pages that they love to read the newspaper itself. When they go online, they stop reading there. They go back to the paper version. Magazines, same. Well, there is this law 805, which makes government sites has to be senior and handicap accessible. So we will see the examples, like this is from the National Institute of Health. Okay, there's a misspelling there, I just saw it. It's designed seniors in mind with that law. It has separate locations, the colors are used same, and if we go down, everything is separate. Even the menus at the bottom, they used contradicting colors. And of course, they have that slider. This is another government website. It has exactly the same larger fonts and the same question. Icons have whatever they do on top of them, if not under it. So you know what's going on.
Did you say there's some laws or some regulations that have to be passed?
Yeah, it's Section 805.
Okay.
And these are the apps that you can use, and it's in the repository. You can find it, and it helps a lot. And those resizers puts an icon on your website, so you let the user to change the fonts themselves. Because we usually used to say 14 points or 12 to 14 points are the standard, but we don't want to say it no more because of the size of the screens. So let the user choose whatever they want. And
no, don't forget that. Can you leave it up?
What's that? Sorry. Oh, sure.
Oh.
That back, okay. Well, all these slides will be online, and my Twitter handle is tashan.net. I mean, the website and Twitter handle is at tashan. So I'll hashtag with the WordCamp LAs, so you will be able to find it. Well, as every presentation here, please go to the reviews, review this, and there is a section where you can write your requests, comments, and so on. Please do. I would like to get your feedback and then try to look into those because these are very, very interesting questions and subjects. Thank you very much.